Yvette. Welcome to the Spreckles Theater, home of the 1993 Miss California pageant, the official state finals to Miss America, featuring recording artist Ursula Yvette with Charles McGowan and Dean Harvey. Tonight, one of these 38 representatives will set her sights on the Miss America crown as your new Miss California 1993.
It's all in me. Anything you want done, baby, I'll do it naturally.
Michelle Bukalos. Miss Kern County, Michelle Leanne Brown. Miss Placentia, Jill Ann Connolly. Miss Alameda County, Prima Donna Campbell. Miss Los Angeles County, Christina Cherie Hagel. Miss Santa Cruz County, Christy Lynn Fisher. Miss Merced County, Stephanie Lynn Temple. Miss Napa County, Anne Marie Sparks. Miss Gavilan Hills, Kim Yaffe. Miss San Diego, Lauren Michelle Reynolds. Miss City of Hayward, Shala Magyar. Miss Anaheim, Stacy Nicole Lehman. Miss Santa Clara, Tracy Kathleen Hayes. Miss Garden Grove, Jennifer Ann Nunes. Miss Lake County, Crystal Marie Pettis. Miss Orange County Regional, Audra Murphy. Miss Sonoma County, Layla Michelle Caldwell. Miss Covina, Stacy Jenkins. Miss Gold Country, Rachel Mink. Miss City of Orange, Christy Hayes. Miss Stanislaw County, Crystal Lecker. Miss Mendocino County, April Lynn Drum. Miss Tulare County, Lisa Michelle Duncan. Miss Desert Community, Soraya Hari. Miss Fresno County, Suzette Winchester. Miss Greater Long Beach City, Kimberly Swears. Miss Orange County, Robin Lynn Bedell. Miss Inglewood, Sanaa Robinson. Miss Contra Costa County, Anna Juliet Robinson. Miss Greater San Jose, Mercy Diskin Malik. Miss Greater Riverside County, Celeste Wade. Miss San Francisco, Jennifer Esperante. Miss Sacramento County, Atosa Perusvar. Miss National Orange Show, Alina Yvonne Esparza. Miss Culver City, Kelly Bryant. Miss Marin County, Kathy Brannon. Miss San Joaquin County, Alicia Howard. Patricia Ann Northrup. Something to do about being your master of ceremonies. My name is Lou Susie, and good evening to all of you. Lou, well, thank you. That pleases me because it's captured on videotape, and my ancestors will see that. Thank you, yeah. You remember what I said about, on our first preliminary night, we were talking about having the jitters backstage and a few butterflies. Now, we took care of those on the first preliminary night in very quick fashion. Then on Friday night, we didn't hardly have any at all. But I want to tell you, here it is Saturday for the crowning of Miss California 1993. And those jitters, those butterflies, they're back. But I honestly believe that we'll take care of it shortly. In the wonderful opening production number, I'm Every Woman, let me give you credit for some of those wardrobes that you saw. For example, all of those dresses were a gift of Karen Alexander, those red and navy dresses. Let's hear a nice round of applause for Karen Alexander. And in that same production number, the red and navy shoes were courtesy, as are the swimsuit shoes that you'll see a little bit later on. Frederick Go Leon. Yes. Well, ladies and gentlemen, once again, back on a final night in this beautiful community of San Diego, California. There really is excitement in the air. And I'm so very pleased that you're here because, as we've now demonstrated to you veterans of two preliminary nights, that our 38 contestants vying for the title of Miss California are indeed very professional and very confident. They've prepared. I started to hear a round of applause because you agreed with that statement. How many agree that they have exhibited a great deal of professionalism? They have. Yes, they have indeed. What is it about all of these women? Just to get to this stage, they have established goals in their young lives, and they've worked very hard to try to accomplish the final mission. Are we proud of them? Certainly. We're very proud of them. Tonight is their night. But I'm joined on stage by an individual that a few years ago, we were very proud of her then. Most of us, it was a long distance love affair. We saw her just via national television. But tonight, we truly are blessed to have Miss America 1987 on our stage. But let me tell you something. She's in our community tonight with her husband Todd, her young son Brian, and yet another new member of the family to come along in the near future. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss America 1987, Kelly Cash.
sunshine day. It's gonna be a bright, sunshiny day. I think I can make it now, the pain is gone. All of those bad feelings have disappeared. Well, here is that rainbow I've been searching for. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. Look all around, nothing but blue skies. Look straight ahead, nothing but blue skies. Heaven, but the eye can see it shine somewhere. Bright light somewhere, invite me to come there and love. Inside my head, I hear them all ringing. Come on. Who knows, maybe all the visions that I see, maybe waiting just for me to say, take me that way. Let me see it. Let me feel it. I know it's so, I know that it really can be.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kelly Cash.
Woo!
Oh, I think the baby moved.
Well,
either it was saying yay or shut up. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I was going to say you were hot only two different ways. I mean, warm and warm. Hot musically, but you're telling me there's a third way?
The baby? Oh,
yes.
Well, all these pregnant women and former pregnant women know about the blood rushing and being hot, so I think I'm going to be fine. Actually, I'm from the South, so I don't sweat. I perspire.
You don't even glisten, huh?
Sometimes I glow.
Oh.
Actually, I think I'm sweating, so I better shut up.
Kelly, what would you say if I gave you a gift?
Oh, I would love it.
All right.
Especially if it says what I'm supposed to say.
Are yours, yes.
Hey.
Oh, by the way.
Boy, I'm not saying anything I'm supposed to say.
By the way, Kelly, my name is Lou.
Lou.
You see that three-letter word there?
It says, Hello, Lou.
Hello,
Thanks
Lou.
For that kind introduction. You know, that was a very kind introduction.
Was it?
It was. I heard. I mean, I was actually listening. I was, vocalizing and all that.
My pleasure.
And listen, thanks for the opportunity to come here and be part of the Miss California pageant. I live in Escondido. I mean, I'm just like a hop, skip, and a jump. So I'm just...
Well, now, I am learning something brand new. I mean, I met your husband,
Did
Todd, earlier.
That?
And your youngster is just gorgeous.
I know.
Yes, Brian.
Yeah. Oh, well, you know what? It's Brady, but that's okay.
It was a B word.
It's one of those B words. Yeah,
yeah,
it was a B word. He's pretty cute. He's actually, he left, and so he's with the sitter. I know the contestants will be thrilled that while they're singing, we won't hear, Mommy, Mommy, or whatever. But some of the things that you have said about the Miss America organization as you started and as we were introduced are very, very true. The women that I competed with at the Miss America pageant have all gone on to very successful careers, and the scholarship opportunities in the pageant have taken them very far and helped them in their careers, and it's been real exciting to be a part of that.
I do have a question, though, as a tag on that, though, Kelly. As I've traveled throughout California, that's been the depth of my experience as an MC, and I've produced some shows and been an ED, and I'm family. I hope they accept me as family to pageantry. But I have heard from many contestants that the scholarships were wonderful. They were very useful.
Mm-hmm.
They were of so much benefit that they're at the top of the list. But they also went on to tell me, Kelly, ladies and gentlemen, that just the sheer experience alone had benefit. Do you see it that way as well?
Oh, well, absolutely. For those of you who don't know, I was Miss Tennessee before I was Miss America, and at my local pageant, at my state pageant, and then at Miss America, the interview part of the competition prepared me for so many areas of life, for press conferences and other interviews, for job opportunities when you're trying to, you know, show every side of yourself, show yourself your best. And that's another thing that these girls take home with them, not only the scholarship, which every girl on the stage will have a scholarship, but the experience that will help them in many aspects of their life.
Kelly, it's not on your cards. This comes straight from the heart. Take me back a few years.
Hold it. No,
oh,
it's right there.
Yeah, I'm going to add something. No.
It says, take me back. No.
I want to hear your reflections of that very first media interview back in 1987, the morning after you were crowned. Tell me about it.
You don't.
I don't?
That was, I was well prepared, but it was a little difficult. I was able to get through it, but I don't know, having people fire so many questions at you and with so many subjects and thinking, why do they care about that? You know, it was really interesting, and I ended up with some, you know, some good press after that, but it really opened my eyes to...
Were there some deeply personal questions?
Yes, deeply personal. I can't believe you're asking that.
Well, I don't want to relive
it. But it opened my eyes. It was a great experience because I look at people in the entertainment field and politicians much differently now because I know that they're up against a lot. And but of course, the pageant prepares you for all that, and so I was prepared, but it still opened my eyes a little bit.
When you look back at that time of your life, who really made it possible for you to become Miss America, besides yourself, of course?
Well, you know what I'm going to say.
What are you going to say?
My mom.
Oh.
I'm telling.
Is mom here tonight?
No, my parents live in Memphis, Tennessee, and my mom of course I was raised by both my parents, but my dad's in the Navy, so he was gone a lot. And mom was always there to encourage me to play the piano when I wanted to quit, and to encourage me to perform, and she encouraged me in the pageant. She wasn't one of those stage mothers. I didn't enter my first pageant until I was a junior in college, so she was not a stage mother, but so supportive, always had her prayers, and moms have a direct connection to God. I want everyone to know, and I haven't gotten it yet. Maybe it's when your children get older, but they've got a direct connection, and her encouragement and prayers and all that were just... It was just tremendous, yeah.
I know by your reputation of the year that you offered us as Miss America, I know from previous conversations today that you enjoyed your time in that capacity. You've stayed affiliated with our program, and you're very proud. That's one of our key words,
yeah,
isn't it? You are proud of what we do.
I am.
Judges, on the other hand, make it possible, in part. They see someone on this stage, and they draw you off of that stage, give you a title, and then give you great responsibility.
They have a difficult job.
Yes. What do you say we meet our judges
okay.
for this year? Good. I have the pleasure of introducing the first judge tonight, Janice Walker Malloy, the former executive director and business manager of Miss Alabama. That's down in your part of the country. She has an extensive background, ladies and gentlemen, in dance and voice. Has judged over 30 Miss America state pageants. She's a resident currently of Birmingham, Alabama, chosen the Outstanding Woman of the Year some 4 years in a row. This woman is hot as well. It's my pleasure to introduce the first judge tonight, Janice Walker Malloy. It's your turn, Janice. Yes. You get this handsome fellow right there.
I know this handsome fellow because I've emceed the pageant that he's from. This, our next judge is Larry Ostenkopf. Mr. Ostenkopf is the chairman of the board of the Miss Nebraska Scholarship Pageant, which has a huge population. I want everyone to know that was just for Larry. He is a graduate of Nebraska Wesleyan University and served as a logistics specialist on the headquarters staff of the U.S. Army Strategic Communications Command in Alaska. A California welcome for my friend, Mr. Larry Ostenkopf.
Well, he's our friend, too. You bet.
Our friend.
Yes, okay. Can you share? Our next judge, Deli, is Dr. Joyce Gattis. She is the Dean of the College of Professional Studies and Fine Arts, where? San Diego State University, where she manages some 14 diverse departments, including art, drama, and music. Dr. Gattis is a graduate of the Institute for Educational Management at Harvard University, holds a PhD in counseling from UC Berkeley. Dr. Joyce Gattis.
Good
Our next judge is Hal Laster. He is the Assistant Dean for Admissions and Student Services at the University of Cincinnati Conservatory of Music. Mr. Laster is a former member of the U.S. Air Force Band. This summer, he will do his second cross-country bicycle trip for the Ryan White AIDS Foundation. Please welcome another one of my and our friends, Mr. Hal Laster.
Hello, Hal. This introduction belongs to the final member of our scholarship panel tonight, Jackie Brunson by name. Let me tell you about Jackie. Ms. Brunson is a member of the board of directors of the Miss New Mexico Pageant Association, a veteran judge of some 26 state pageants. She graduated a couple of years ago, magna cum laude, from the University of Texas with a degree in textile and clothing design. Jackie Brunson. Good evening.
Hi, Jackie.
Well, now that kiss was thrown really in your direction.
I'm going to see her next week. I'm going to New Mexico.
I see. Okay.
I'm just hopping around. You know.
For the last two evenings, I've had the pleasure of introducing these two fellows off to our left. And tonight, for the very first time, I'm going to do it correctly.
Okay.
All right.
I'm going to follow along.
Oh, small wonder. Our certified public accountants handling the tabulations for this evening's activities from the San Diego-based firm of Hawkins and Scott are David Hawkins. Stand up, take a bow. Thank you, David. And Mr. Don Glitchka from Hawkins and Scott. Thank you. Thank you very much. We appreciate you being a part of our program. Let's get on with the rest of our show.
Everything must change. Nothing stays the same.
To stop these folks from saying hello to their good friends. Let's hear it some more. Right there. You are wonderful. Okay, here we go. Kelly, this is a brand new concept for this audience right now. We'll give them a moment to kind of settle in. We're about to announce the top 10. And as Kelly and I announce the top 10s as individuals, when they hear their name, one at a time, they're going to step forward and guess what they're going to do? Immediately go into evening gown competition. Wow. Kelly, how would you like to be in their shoes now? All that initial surge of excitement and then step up and be calm, cool, and collected.
I don't know about being in their shoes, but I'd love to be in their clothes.
Oh, from Sherry Hill, yes.
All right.
You are ready, I know you.
I don't know.
Ladies and gentlemen, the top 10 begins with Miss Azusa Curry Whelan. Isn't that exciting, Corey? I'm going to open up this envelope because this has a question going back to your platform experience with your judges. So right now, concentrate very carefully on this question. And once you step just a little closer to the microphone, because these folks really want to hear what you have to say. Listen carefully, please. How can we break the cycle of child abuse? The cycle. Member of our top 10 is Miss Contra Costa County, Anna Juliet Robinson.
Hi, Anna.
Hi.
Again, we have a question concerning her platform issue. Anna, what are you doing as an individual to promote the protection of the environment?
Well, aside from the work I do with kids, I really try. There's so much we can do as individuals. For starters, I try not to drive anywhere that I don't have to, and I ride my bike because within biking distance. I bring my own canvas grocery bag to the grocery store so that I'm not adding to the landfills and adding a bunch of extra trash that we won't use. I also do things like I buy ozone-friendly hairspray, and I don't buy disposable razors. There's permanent ones you can buy that you replace the cartridges. And I really try to encourage all my friends to recycle as much as they can, not to drive wherever they don't need to. And we do tons of recycling in my own home. Thank you.
Thank you, Anna.
I'm going to ask, first of all of our contestants, to just listen to my voice carefully. You know how excited I can be, but listen to what I say. The third member of our top 10, Miss Orange County, Robin Lynn Bedell.
Hi, Robin. This is your question. Should there be federal or state laws to legislate the rights of the homeless person? Federal or state laws?
I believe that there already are laws. What we need is consistent application of them. If we get together and work together, we can apply those laws from the bottom up, and then we'll be successful, and we will eradicate the problem.
Thank you, Robin.
Long will this next contestant remember this moment. She'll remember her friend Lou saying, Miss San Francisco, Jennifer Esperante.
Hi,
Lou, take your time.
Thank you, Kelly. Is it really possible to take a positive thought, to take a positive thought platform to the projects where there is so much poverty and despair?
Absolutely. First of all, regardless, we all have troubles in our life, and there are times when we feel down and out, and it feels like there is no worth living. But there's one personal thing that we all have in life and that we share in common, and that is the privilege of choice. We can choose to succeed or we can choose to fail. We can choose to win or we can choose to lose. And it's a matter of feeling positive in yourself and growing in that vein. Thank you very much.
Thank you. For the fifth name of our top ten, I have a special request. Let me get out the entire title before you just let it all out and go gaga. Got it? Full title is Miss Orange County Regional, Audra Murphy. And Audra saying, take your time, Lou. Thank you. Thank you. Your question, Audra. What role should the family play in dealing with sexuality? The family. What role should it play? Thank you, Audra. Have we done now exactly one half?
Yes,
of
go
our
on,
top ten?
Please.
All right. The sixth member of this year's top ten is Miss Garden Grove, Jennifer M. Nunes. Yes, it is. See, we built this into the script to give you a chance just to take a deep breath. You ready for your question? How can you, Jennifer, as an individual, involve other people in community service to combat juvenile problems?
I would like to serve an example to my community because I know that we all have unique talents that we can contribute to our society. My personal talent happens to be ballet, and I've gone into the neighborhoods of Garden Grove where there's disadvantaged children, and I've taught them dance. I know that we all have special things we can share with others, and I believe that if we learn to share and give up just an hour a week, that our communities will be a better place to live. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Number seven, without any delay, is Miss San Diego, Lauren Michelle Reynolds. Isn't this fun? Yes. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Dad. Yeah. Lauren, how do we educate our young people about the consequences of health damaging behavior?
What we need to do is bring in people who have suffered through diseases that could have been prevented. Bring in somebody who has suffered from an eating disorder to show how devastating it is and how much it affects your life. I believe showing is so much better than telling as a way to get through to children about how important it is to take care of their health. Thank you.
Thank you, Laura. Go to a different part of the state of California now. Yes, we are, because we were in San Diego a moment ago. We're now in Tulare County. Lisa Michelle Duncan.
Hi, Lisa. How do you overcome the denial factor when counseling a person who has an eating disorder?
In overcoming an eating disorder. I think once an eating disorder victim knows that they are supported and that friends and family are there to help them, that's the first step they need in taking that first step of recovery. Thank you.
Thank you, Lisa.
Just because she earned that right because of these judges, we're going to stay in Northern California, Miss San Joaquin County. Alicia Howard is the name. Right there.
Hi, Alicia. How do you seek out the people who want to learn to read, but who are ashamed to come forward?
There's a really big problem in recruiting people, making people come forward for illiterate. Many times people are embarrassed, and that's something that they're ashamed of. So the real problem is in disseminating the message. Also, it's hard to disseminate the message in newspapers because the people that you're trying to target cannot read. So the best way to do that is through the community. Others who cannot read. The best way to do this is one-on-one. Thank you.
Thank you, Alicia. This is it.
Number 10. I know you all want to hear your name. And you know, it's not possible. But this is the name that I bring you and you. Miss City of Orange, Christy Hayes! That's enough to get your adrenaline going, isn't it? Do me a favor, Christy, and just a little bit closer to the mic. We want to hear every word you have to say regarding this platform, subject, and question. With so many negative role models, how can you motivate children to involve them in positive activities?
I would like to take my trampoline into the school system. And the first thing I would like to do is
please congratulate our 28 for being wonderful contestants vying for the title of Miss California. Thank you. We'll see you a little bit later on in the show. Thanks very much. God bless each and every one of you. Now, Kelly Cash, wasn't that exciting, though?
That was so exciting.
Brought
back memories.
In order to set the stage, though, for our talent competition coming up in a few moments, I want you folks, especially those who have been with us for Thursday and Friday and now our final night, to enjoy the wonderful talent of our current Miss California. Here's Patty, Patricia, and Northrop right now. Patricia Ann Northrup, take a curtain bow, Patty. I'm going to call her contestant number one, if you will, and you know that I'm referring to Miss Azusa. Now, save yourself. Here to present a very promising ballad, Once Upon a Dream, from the award-winning London-based musical Jekyll and Hyde, is Miss Azusa Corey J. Wellens.
Lost in love's embrace.
Corey Wellens. Performing a lyrical character dance to a Slavic summer song, music chosen from the homeland of her ancestors, is Anna Juliet Robinson, Miss Contra Costa County. She tells the story of a young girl trying to attract the attention of a handsome but elusive bachelor. Please welcome Miss Contra Costa County, Anna Juliet Robinson. Miss Contra Costa County, Anna Juliet Robinson.
Thank you. Let's go back in history. The French Second Empire. It was a long time ago. La Randonnée takes place during that period. Magda is the individual we find now about to be portrayed by our next contestant. We find Magda at home. She's entertaining. We're in Paris at this time. One of her guests, a poet, tells a tale of sentimental love, which he then asks Magda to actually finish the story, and she does so in aria form. And during the aria, she sings of a heroine and how the heroine learned so much about true love when she was passionately kissed by a student one day. And you'll find when you listen carefully that the passion that she sings about, referring to the heroine, is truly the passion of her very own. Here is Miss Orange County, Robin Bedell.
Give me some
Miss Orange County, Robin Lynn Bedell. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Brazil's Cha-Cha Night. Tonight's star is hot, exciting, and bursting with energy. So sit back and enjoy the show, for the Cha-Cha Queen has arrived. Here she is, Jennifer Esperante, Miss San Francisco. Jennifer Esperante.
Well, if you think I'm going to ask you to be calm, you're wrong. I love every bit of it. If you've got any more of it for Jennifer, you can do it now. You like? All right. Thank you. You'll be tired by midnight tonight. All right. We have a little break in our talent presentations only because we want to make absolutely sure the piano is set. So let me give credit where credit is due on one issue that I want to bring to your attention. During the course of this year, on several different occasions, an absolute gift was made to our Miss California in regards to some evening gowns from the company called Jasmine Curtis. Would you please acknowledge them for us? Thank you, Jasmine Curtis. Thank you very much. You're about to experience a very exciting excerpt from one of Ludwig von Beethoven's most celebrated piano compositions, the Pathetique Sonata. Till I came to this pageant family this year, I'd never heard that phrase. That shows how uninformed I am. But believe me, our next contestant can play it beautifully. She's Miss Orange County Regional, Audra Lynn Murphy. Thank you.
Miss Orange County Regional, Audra Lynn Murphy.
Boy, I remember them pulling out the piano for me at Miss America. I had to sit out there for 2 minutes during the commercial break and look at the judges. Made me a nervous wreck. Once I got that first note out, it was okay, though. All right. From the famous Nutcracker Ballet, Jennifer Ann Nunes, Miss Garden Grove, will perform On Point, Maybe Not, Do You Need Me to Help? I think they've got it. From the famous Nutcracker Ballet, as I just said, Jennifer Ann Nunes, Miss Garden Grove, will perform On Point, a variation from the Waltz of the Flowers. Miss Garden Grove, Jennifer Ann Nunes.
Miss Garden Grove, ladies and gentlemen, Jennifer Ann Nunes. Our next talent patient comes from Miss San Diego. She's going to vocalize for us on a center stage with her own special interpretation of For Once in My Life. She's now center stage. You can start that groundswell of applause for Lauren Reynolds.
Oh, not like it's hurt me before.
Western dancing is to the 90s what the Charleston was to the 20s, the jitterbug was to the 40s, and disco was to the 70s. Combining contemporary country western style with traditional ballet on point, please welcome Lisa Duncan, Miss Tulare County.
Tulare County. Thank you. And thank you. We're surrounded by the news in this great land of ours, radio, television, newspapers. Every day we learn about the human condition. But we listen and watch the news carefully. We see other populations fight for social reform. And every time we hear one of those stories, read about it, it should make us even more so appreciative of those liberties that we enjoy in the United States of America. Our next presentation is pure and simple, Patriotism, as sung by Miss San Joaquin County, Alicia Howard.
Alicia Howard. Trampoline may be considered in the 1996 Olympics as an Olympic exhibition sport. And perhaps in 1996, you may see our next contestant. She will delight you with this fantastic routine. Her name is Christy Hayes, and she is Miss City of Orange.
Pain.
Misty Hayes. Miss City of Orange, and we thank you. We're going to bring up the house lights now because I want to introduce, as we strike the set, before we go off to our intermission, I want to point out some visitors amongst us tonight that I really want you to know. So we need to bring up the house lights just a tad more because we'll want to spot these nice folks. And I'm going to ask you to give a nice spirited round of applause to each and every one of them. The lights need to come up more because I can't see yet. Miss California 1968, Sharon K. Terrell. There you are, right down in the front row. Hello. You represented Torrance, did you not, in the year you became Miss California? This young woman represented Pomona Valley in 1975. Her name then, we know her best by this name, Janet J. Carr. Where are you, Janet? Right there. Hello, my friend. Janet J. Carr, the former Miss Pomona Valley, the former Miss California. Nice to see you. I take you back to 1981. She was Miss Los Angeles. Cheryl Diane Van Cleve. I'm told that Cheryl is here. Would you please rise? We'll give you a spirited hello. There we are. Where? Well, somewhere out there in this beautiful house. Hello, Cheryl Diane Van Cleve. Yay. Oh, in the balcony. God. Now, wait a minute. This gentleman has a very loud voice. You tell me, sir, where Cheryl is. Right there. But these folks down here can't see up there. You've been told to stand up, yes. Cheryl, about 927 people are going to see you at intermission, so make sure you say hello. I understand, and I have this great privilege of introducing Miss Nevada, 1993. I'm sure her pageant was just a short time ago. Mitzi Cox. Where are you, Mitzi? Well, right there. Congratulations. How long ago was your selection? Thursday. Today's Saturday, just past Thursday. Well, a double thank you to Mitzi Cox. And this will come as a great surprise to this next individual. In 1982, now a lot of you are thinking, what was I doing in 82? Well, if you were in the Miss America program and you happened to be back in the New England states and you were Miss New Hampshire, stand up, Amy Balker Glassover, if you will, please. Where are you, Amy? Oh, hello. I know that does surprise you. And before we go away for our 10 or 15 minute intermission, I want you to see this individual during the break and tell her what an outstanding venue this building is. What an incredible base of history for the Southland. The owner of the Spreckles Theater is Jacqueline Littlefield. Jacqueline? There you are. Thank you for your gracious hospitality. That does take care of some VIP introductions, certainly takes care of talent. And before I turn you loose, you did think talent was number one tonight, didn't you? Hot, huh? They were wonderful. Enjoy your break. We'll be back with the conclusion right after a short break.
Cause I don't know how to love you my way. You give me fever
when you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight.
Fever
in the morning, fever all through the night. Romeo loved Juliet, Juliet she felt the same.
Julie, baby, you're my flame. He gave a fever.
Sunday.
My eyes light up when you call my name, 'cause I know you're gonna treat me right. You give me fever when you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight. Fever in the morning, fever all through the night. Everybody's got the fever. That is something you should know. Fever isn't such a new scene. Fever started long ago. When you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight. Fever in the morning, fever all through the night. Give me fever when you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight. Fever in the morning, fever all through the night. What a lovely way to burn.
We welcome our top 10 contestants in swimsuit competition, beginning with Miss Azusa, Corey Wellens. Miss Contra Costa County, Anna Juliet Robinson. Miss Orange County, Robin Lynn Bedell. Miss San Francisco, Jennifer Esperante. Miss Orange County Regional, Audra Murphy. Miss Garden Grove, Jennifer Ann Nunes. Miss San Diego, Lauren Michelle Reynolds. Miss Tulare County, Lisa Michelle Duncan. Miss San Joaquin County, Alicia Howard. Miss City of Orange, Christy Hayes. Please welcome back to our Miss California stage, Miss America 1987, Kelly Cash.
Did he need a stronger hand? Did he need a lighter touch? Was I soft or was I tough? Did I give enough? Did I give too much? did I ever turn away? Would I be there when he called? If he walked into my life today? Should I blame the times I pampered him? Or blame the times I bossed him? What a shame. I never really found the boy before I loved him. The years a little fast. Was his world a little free? Was there too much of a crowd? If he walked into my life today, if I fell without people, walked into my life
Kelly, why don't we spend some time and chit-chat?
Okay,
do you
about,
mind?
About what?
Well, I was just in the wings.
The second of my two dresses that I can wear.
You're running out of the wardrobe rapidly?
Yes.
Is that why you were saying, wouldn't it have been nice if somebody had been able to offer some wardrobe during your visit here?
Yes,
now I understand.
Great.
Damn,
I met that weird part of pregnancy, you know.
No, you and I didn't meet until about 1 o'clock this afternoon.
But I feel like your family.
Oh. Oh, thank you. A
kinda
dream
like
come
my father.
True. I just don't know how much longer I can keep dyeing my hair.
My father-in-law's here tonight, and I'm sure he thinks that he's the only person I tease, and now he's found out that there is somebody else.
Gosh. No, but if we could get serious, Lucy and Desi got serious every once in a while. I was standing in the wings. And I was, without equivocation, admiring your talent. And talent such as yours should be used professionally. Are you pursuing a professional career?
Well, as I said, I've entered the Miss America pageant for also the career opportunity. I didn't really know, even though some of you may know I'm the niece of Johnny Cash. Yes.
You know, I was trying to ask that question, but I thought she must be asked that all the time.
Yes.
Okay, you have.
But, you know, even though I have that in my blood, in my family, Miller Rumble.
Little boy named Sue.
I just always knew that it would be really difficult to get into a performing career. And so, you know, I never really thought, even though I pursued it, in the back of my mind, I thought, I don't know, it's so hard. But the Miss America pageant, once I saw that as an opportunity, opened the door. And for 6 years, I've been able to travel professionally, singing Christian music and having a speaking career with my first love. And last night, it's hard to believe that I'm here, but last night in Huntington, West Virginia was where I debuted my first gospel album, and it was last night.
Well.
And then I got on the plane this morning. I got up at 4:30, which was 1:30. So my voice sounds lower than usual. It's I'm not trying to be sexy. It's just that I left my voice in West Virginia, or part of it. Some of the higher tones.
You can't deny your sexuality, believe me. Yes, you're a sexy person.
Oh, okay.
I mean, you can't hide that. Gee, wish.
Whatever you say.
So
I'm not really sure how that fit in. But come on.
I'm off in my own little old world.
It's my blonde hair. All of a sudden, I was like, what are you talking about?
Well, if it's 9.5 minutes after 10 here, what's your body telling you?
That it's 9.5 minutes after 12,
ooh,
I think. But I feel great. And I tell you what, we have lovely girls behind us, and we have a beautiful number.
Do we?
We do.
Your applause, their applause for you, gets it going. All ladies right. and gentlemen, Kelly Cash, Miss America. Patricia Northrup.
Say it again, though.
In her farewell appearance, this is, of course, Miss California, Patricia Ann Northrup.
Now.
For our children, in the future, our Miss California will impact thousands of children's lives. I thank my family and each and every person here who believed in me and supported me. You trusted and opened your hearts to someone you barely knew. But I walked away from each experience this year knowing that I was loved. Someone loves me. To my family, all the children I met this year, and each volunteer here in California, I will always remember what you've given to me, both inside and out. Someone like me truly loves you.
'Cause someone like you loves someone like me. And suddenly, nothing is the same. A new way to live and a new way to love. Now that someone like you found me, oh, someone like you loves someone like me. You touched my heart. I will never be the same. My heart's taken wing, and I feel.
Ursula Yvette. Thank you, Ursula. Miss California, Patty Northrup. Thank you. Beautiful. Just beautiful. Oh, Kelly, what a time we've had tonight, Thursday and Friday. Let me take you back just a few minutes ago. Remember when Patty made that gracious entry during that production number called Black Velvet? Let me tell you that those black velvet gowns were flown in from the East Coast especially for this show, along with the representative Sherry Hill, to make sure that they fit as beautifully as you saw them in that production number. For Sherry Hill, now would be a wonderful time to say thank you and thank you. Well, I can see that the girls appreciate it, yes. I'm going to introduce someone, Kelly, that I am pretty sure that you probably know. I know that throughout all of the activities that one of our national field directors for the Miss America pageant has been here observing our activities.
Oh, no.
We're going to take a spotlight and identify Mr. Tom O'Rourke. Mr. O'Rourke from Miss America Atlantic City Style. There you are, sir. Thank you so much for being with us. During these past two evenings of preliminary competition, Kelly, ladies and gentlemen, and contestants, we've seen many outstanding talents. Miss California pageant would like to recognize five, not four. The old script used to say four. The new script says five contestants to be honored tonight for having the highest score in talent competition, but not selected to be amongst the top 10 finalists. We're all anxious to hear, are we not?
I am.
Yes, Kelly. Well, coming from someone of your talented capabilities, please extend a thank you to Miss Gavilan Hills, Kim Yaffe. Yes, what do you do? Stand right there. Stand right there. All right. Okay. Right, you're just about fine. You're Kim Yaffe, huh? You're sure? All right, I'm going to leave you now.
But you'll be joined soon.
All right. Our second of five non-finalist talent winners is Miss Los Angeles County, Christina Hegel. Miss Sonoma County, Layla Michelle Caldwell. Miss Gold Country, Rachel Mink. Miss Culver City, Kelly Bryant. Congratulations, ladies, on your accomplishments. All right, start the applause all again. Let's do it for these five. Well, now you're probably...
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's just about time to name the woman who will be representing the state of California in Atlantic City in September at the Miss America pageant for 1994. From a field of 38 contestants, we now have 10 finalists who you've seen throughout the evening. Let's once again acknowledge the accomplishments of these 10 women as we prepare to select and crown Miss California 1993.
Yes.
First, let's welcome back Miss Azusa, Corey Wellens.
Very nice. Very nice, Corey. A reflection of your ear, in part. Yes.
Our next finalist, as you all know, is Miss Contra Costa County, Anna Juliet Robinson. Our next finalist is Miss Orange County, Robin Lynn Bedell. Thank you.
Miss San Francisco, Jennifer Esperanti. Welcome back, Miss Orange County Regional, Audra Murphy. Garden Grove, Jennifer Ann Nunes. Welcome, Miss San Diego, Lauren Michelle Reynolds. Lisa Michelle Duncan. Welcome, Miss San Joaquin County, Alicia Howard. Thank you.
there she disappeared again into the ceiling. Yes.
We sure thank our local pageants, and why don't we hear it for our local pageants for putting together these videos so that you, the audience, can see a little bit more about our finalists. We thank you.
Thank you very much. And ladies, if you'd join back together again, please, as we worked in rehearsal here, we need you to stand together. Kelly, you couldn't see. Kelly, you couldn't see where you were standing, but I could see the auditing team from Hawkins and Scott watching all of those videos. So that all-important piece of paper that you and I wonder, will it be ready, is...
Must be ready.
Ready. Let me just say, we're going to make these final announcements. Kelly's going to get the card. May I take just a peek?
Oh, I guess so.
Let's both take a peek.
Okay.
All right. This is the hardest thing an MC has to learn, is whether you read from the top or the bottom.
Let's see.
We're going to read from the top. Yes.
Okay.
All right. Let's look at those names. All very familiar names.
My name's not on there.
Good. Yeah. Okay. May I take the first one or shall you?
Go right ahead.
Oh, you are so nice. Ladies and gentlemen, now is the time to say the fourth runner-up to the title of Miss California 1993 is Miss Azusa Curry Wellen.
And our third runner-up to Miss California 1993 is Miss San Joaquin, Alicia Howard.
And you all recall a young woman from Southern California who is now going to be your second runner-up, Jennifer Nunes.
And our first runner-up to Miss California 1993 is Miss Orange County, Robin Bedell.
And except for the parties that follow tonight and all the wonderful congratulations, I want to thank Kelly Cash for joining us tonight to be our co-MC. Thank you, Kelly. This next name, Kelly, might belong to a woman who can follow in your footsteps.
Oh, I hope so.
Let's see what happens to the brand new Miss California. She'll compete in September for the title for Miss America. Say hello to Lisa Duncan, Miss Tulare. The former Miss Tulare County is now Miss California, Lisa Duncan. Congratulations to Lisa, to all of our contestants, and to all of you, a very special good night.